Today on Retro Tech, I want to take a closer look at the Tate demo. Now that is Tate, T-A-T-E, not pronounced Tate, but Tate. So let's go through what that really means a little bit. Let me show you some examples really quick of Tate. To understand Tate, let's first look at the term itself. When in Google Translator, I was able to put in vertical display and I got the word Tate Gata. So Tate is referring to the fact that the display is in the vertical orientation while you're using it for gaming. Tate gaming has been around since the late 1970s, as the first Tate arcade shoot-em-up was launched in 1978, and that was Space Invaders. And Space Invaders was a huge hit. Due to the success of Atari and Space Invaders, other companies began to make shoot-em-ups, and it really dominated the arcade gaming scene in the 1980s. And during the 1970s and early 80s, Atari was pretty much the king of arcade gaming. The next extremely popular shoot-em-up of the time would have been in 1981 with the release of Galaga. And Galaga, again, was a great success and led to a boom of other shoot-em-up style arcade games. There was also games like Mrs. Pac-Man and Donkey Kong that were early games that all used a vertical setup with their monitor displays. This success ultimately led to the very first home gaming console with the Tate setup, that is the Vectrex console. It was released in 1982 at the end of the year for a retail price of $199. With today's inflation, that would equal about $500 for this gaming console. Unfortunately, this was released right before the video game crash of 1983, and the Vectrex ultimately died in the 1984 market year. All right, so first let's take a look at the display we're going to be using. I want to show you some examples. This is a CRT. This is just a standard consumer grade CRT. And you can see this is not really built for this kind of a Tate setup. It doesn't have any way really to set it safely on its side without it getting unstable. I don't recommend you use anything like this, any type of CRT that's not in a cube shape, and I'll show you what I mean in a second. So remember, the reason where this is not a good idea is it's very unstable, it could fall. Also, things can fall around inside your monitor. If something breaks off or a piece of plastic or something else is inside there free and it moves around and hits an important component, it could short out the TV and cause a lot of trouble. So one of the best displays for Tate is going to be a professional video monitor or a broadcast monitor that has a cube shape and design. It also has a built-in degaussing button in case you have any color purity issues when you flip it on its side. Sometimes you will see discoloration due to the magnetism changing on the PVM or monitor that you're using.
So you can already see from our demo that I decided to use the Sony PVM2950, and it's already turned on its side. You can see how the design is very friendly to turn it on its side. It's not unstable at all. The other good thing is the board and chassis parts inside are all stable and secured with screws, which is very important. If your PVM or CRT is not secured properly with screws, you can really damage it by turning it on its side. I'll be using the RGB lines, and they are already connected here with an RGB adapter, and then we've got our power cable connected to our monitor. This is just a standard RGB setup with C-Sync on the console. Now for today's console, I will be using a Dreamcast. This is just a standard North American Dreamcast. And we'll be using the standard output, and we'll be getting a 240p signal to our monitor using SCART. And again, we need a C-Sync signal so that it will display properly on our monitor.
So the big surprise here is that there's not really much of any kind of setting or adjustment that you make to the hardware to do this Tate setup. This is all software. So this game has a mode where I can turn it from the normal mode it's in right now, and I can turn it to the Tate mode, but it's called arcade mode, but I'll show you that right now. All right, so all I've done at this point is I've hit start and I've pulled up my game options is right here. And on this, we've got a screen selector on our options. You can see right here it says mode, horizontal. Now that's the normal horizontal mode. I switched it to arcade, and that's all I do. So guys, this is something that's only available through the software. It's not something that you trick the monitor into doing. This is something that's all software based. And once you set it, it'll go like that and stay like that. So let's take a look at this game and show you what it is.
Let's take a look at this bundle of games here. These are all from a company that makes and produces Dreamcast titles as well as Neo Geo titles. Aftermarket, these are all homebrew games. These are a couple shmups. And this is Gunlord, which is pretty well known and just a first-person shooter. But today's game is this Neo XYX, and the reason I've picked this title is it allows for a horizontal mode as well as a Tate mode.
All right, so even though the Sega Dreamcast has a pretty nice controller that plays well with these games, I'd still prefer to have some kind of high-quality arcade stick to use. I never had a good arcade stick for the Sega Dreamcast specifically, but I do have a great Hori stick for the PlayStation 2, so I was able to connect that controller with this. It says EMS on the top. We'll take a closer look at it in a second, but this is an adapter that allows me to have a PlayStation 2 controller, and it goes straight into the Dreamcast.
Unfortunately, this is not a high quality adapter. However, it does get the job done. You can see right on the top, we've got our input side here that allows us to connect any PlayStation 2 controller. This button on the side helps us change between basically button setups, but you can see this is the Dream Card memory unit. See how mine is wobbly? Parts on this just seem to fall apart over time due to cold solder joints.
Okay, so maybe you can see me over here. I've got my adapter plugged up, and I just wanted to show you that it works great. If you see, I'm just hitting the buttons, and it really, you get to have a lot more fun using this arcade stick playing these games than you would with just the standard controller. So even though the product is really low quality and probably will require some repairs, it still works very well, and I don't really know of any other options to get a Dreamcast signal converted over to a PlayStation style arcade stick. All right, so that's pretty much it. I know it's not as technical as maybe you thought, but all it is it's really just all software. So the Dreamcast has a couple titles like this one that are rare and homebrewed that will play shmups like this. So this one specifically does this Neo XYX. The Sega Saturn came out with a few titles that would do the same thing, and some other systems might have also, especially Japanese style systems that were disc based. Now you might be able to get some ROMs or some kind of programming hack that will allow you to take ROMs on either a RetroPie device or a computer that you might use with emulation that could turn the screen settings on there so that you could hook that up to your monitor also as another option. But this is probably the easiest where you can just stick with the original hardware and get it to do what it was made to do. So that's it. All I did was turn the TV sideways, set up the software properly, and the Tate was ready to go. So that's going to take care of today's episode. Please let me know what you think, and thanks again for watching Retro Tech.